an alligator. I'm a mama, papa, coming for you. I'm the space invader.
The night sky is decorated with many shimmering constellations. Ancient observers were able to recognize these groups of stars as the years went on, and they incorporated these findings into their culture and folklore. Visible in the northern hemisphere from late fall to early winter, Cetus is the fourth largest constellation in the sky. Best translated as Great Whale or Sea Monster, Cetus is located around the other water-related constellations, Aquarius, Eridanus, and Pisces. Alpha Ceti is also known as Menkar, which derives from the Arabic word meaning nostril. Despite its name, the star is only the second brightest in the constellation. Alpha Ceti is an M-class red giant that is 67 parsecs from Earth, almost 1400 times as bright as our Sun, and burns at about 4000 degrees Kelvin. Lambda Ceti is a B-class blue giant star. This star was also at one point traditionally known as Menkar, but that name is now used to refer to Alpha Ceti. Lambda Ceti is 177 parsecs away and 650 times as bright as the Sun. This star burns at nearly 11,600 Kelvin. Mu Ceti is an A-class blue giant star 26 parsecs from Earth. It is 7.5 times brighter than our Sun, and burns at 7,200 Kelvin. C2 Ceti is an A-class blue giant, 60 parsecs away. Burning at 10,600 Kelvin, it is 77 times brighter than our Sun. Gamma Ceti is probably the most interesting star in this constellation. That is because it is, in fact, a triple star system 24 parsecs away. The A and B components are revolving around each other, while the C component lies further away. Gamma Ceti A is an A-class blue main sequence star, B is an F-class white main sequence star, and C is a K-class red dwarf. The system outputs a luminosity 20 times greater than that of our Sun, and Gamma Ceti A, the dominant star, burns at 8,600 Kelvin. Ooh, keep your electric on, baby. Delta Ceti is a B-class blue-white subgiant 200 parsecs away. At 22,000 Kelvin, Delta Ceti burns 4,000 times brighter than our Sun. Omicron Ceti is a binary star system 107 parsecs from Earth, better known as Mira. Mira A is an M-class pulsating red giant star, meaning its luminosity fluctuates. Mira A's luminosity averages at around 8900 times that of our Sun and burns at 3000 Kelvin. Mira B is a white dwarf in the D-class that is stealing away some of Mira A's mass. This is a special degenerate class for white dwarfs that can no longer sustain nuclear fusion. The specific D-class spectral types are used to describe the composition of the atmosphere of the white dwarf. In Mira B's case, DA means that the star is still hydrogen-rich. Zeta Ceti is a binary star system 72 parsecs from Earth, also known as Beta Kaidos, Arabic for Belly of the Sea Monster. Zeta Ceti commonly refers to the A component of the system, as the B component is usually disregarded due to its distance. Both components are K-class red-orange giants. Beta Kaidos is 230 times brighter than the Sun and burns at 4600 Kelvin. Theta Ceti is a K-class red giant star, 35 parsecs from Earth. Theta Ceti burns 40 times brighter than the Sun at 4,700 Kelvin. Eta Ceti is a K-class red-orange giant, 38 parsecs from Earth. Eta Ceti is 87 times brighter than the Sun at 4,500 degrees Kelvin.
Light the real thing on me.
Tau Ceti is a G-class yellow main sequence star, 3.7 parsecs from Earth. Tau Ceti burns at 4,500 degrees Kelvin and produces a fifth of our Sun's light. Given its similarity to our own Sun and its close proximity, Tau Ceti has been the fixation on astronomers seeking extraterrestrial life in conditions similar to ours.
The Church of Man Love is such a holy place to be.
Eta Ceti is a K-class orange giant star 30 parsecs away, and the brightest star in the constellation, despite its name. Eta Ceti is also known as Deneb Kaitos, meaning Southern Tail of Cetus in Arabic. It is 130 times brighter than the Sun and burns at 4,800 degrees Kelvin.
Make me, baby. Make me know you really care. Make me jump into the air.
Iota Ceti is a K-class white-orange bright giant star that is 84 parsecs away. Iota Ceti also goes by Deneb Kaitos Shamali, which is Arabic for Northern Tail of Cetus. The star burns 400 times brighter than the Sun and burns at about 4,500 degrees Kelvin. In Greek mythology, Cetus is closely tied with the life of Perseus. When the Queen of Argos bore a daughter, Acrisius, her husband, visited the oracle at Delphi, disappointed in not having a son. The oracle warned him that he would be murdered by his grandson. Acrisius locked Danae in a chamber to thwart the oracle's prophecy. Danae's chamber was dark, and the only opening was through a small crack in the ceiling. The god-king Zeus became infatuated with the beautiful Argive princess, and she had given birth to his son, Perseus. Unwilling to kill the son of Zeus, but still fearful for his life, Acrisius cast Danae and the young Perseus into the sea in a wooden chest. The chest found its way to the island of Seriphos, ruled by the king Polydectes. The two were found by Dides, brother to the king, who provided them shelter and did everything in his power to conceal their presence. He was successful for many years, but Polydectes would eventually learn of their existence, and as soon as he laid eyes on Danae, fell in love with her. Polydectes repeatedly attempted to seduce Danae and even asked her hand in marriage, but Danae rejected each of his advances. The king refused to allow his pride to be tainted with the rejection of a princess, and so he resolved to win her heart by eliminating the biggest obstacle in their relationship, her son. Polydectes devised a plan and held a banquet, and under royal orders, required each guest to bring a horse as tribute to Hippodamia, the princess of Pisa. Just as he had planned, Perseus came to him and explained that, due to his poverty, he owned no horse. Asking for an alternative gift to pay as tribute, Perseus was told to fetch the head of Medusa. Legend has it that Medusa is the only mortal of the three Gorgon sisters. Once a beautiful woman, Medusa was the exception to her family of hideous monsters. Poseidon had become infatuated with her and raped her in the temple of Athena. As punishment for defiling her temple, Athena transformed Medusa into a snake-haired monster whose gaze would turn living creatures to stone. Ironically, Medusa had become the most hideous of her sisters. Athena advised Perseus to seek out the Hesperides, or the nymphs of the evening and the golden light of sunsets, to obtain weapons to help him kill Medusa. Perseus encountered the Grae, immortal sisters of the Gorgon Medusa, who shared one eye and one tooth between the three of them. Perseus seized the eye from them as they passed it around and held it for ransom, demanding that they tell him where to find the Hesperides. When the sisters led him to the nymphs, he kept his word and returned the eye. The Hesperides provided him with a knapsack to safely contain the severed head of Medusa. Zeus produced a sword and Hades' cap of invisibility to grant him stealth, and Hermes and Athena gave him flight-granting winged sandals and a polished shield, respectively. Moving onward to the cave where Medusa slept, Perseus tactfully used the reflection of his shield to see Medusa and behead her. From her neck sprung Pegasus, the winged horse. Moving onward, Perseus visited the Titan Atlas, seeking hospitality. Upon his refusal, Atlas was turned to stone and was transformed into a range of mountains. On his way back to the kingdom of Seriphos, Perseus stopped by the kingdom of Ethiopia. Queen Cassiope had proclaimed that her daughter, Andromeda, was just as beautiful as the Nereids, or sea nymphs. This angered Poseidon, who sent forth the sea monster, Cetus, to plague the kingdom. The oracle of Amon proclaimed that the only way to satisfy Cetus was to sacrifice Andromeda. In hopes of satisfying the sea monster so that his kingdom would be spared, the king had stripped his daughter naked and chained her to a rock on the shore for Cetus to devour. The fate of Cetus varies in different versions of the tale. In some versions, Perseus kills Cetus with his sword. Alternatively, he uses the head of Medusa to turn it to stone. Perseus then goes on to marry Andromeda, much to the dismay of Phineas, her previous suitor, to whom she was promised prior to the ordeal. A quarrel between the two at the wedding resulted in Phineas turning to stone. Perseus and Andromeda had 7 sons and 2 daughters. When Andromeda died, Athena placed her in the stars, and Perseus went on to return to Seriphos. When he learned of his mother's refuge to avoid the advances of Polydectes, Perseus revealed the head of Medusa and turned the king to stone, making Dides the rightful king, with Danae as his companion. Perseus then went on to gratefully return his god-given gifts to Athena. Perseus was curious to meet his grandfather and set out to return to the kingdom of Argos. At this point, Perseus had garnered enough reputation to his name, and his grandfather, Acrisius, learned of his return to the kingdom and went into exile to the kingdom of Larissa to avoid Perseus. Unbeknownst to him, Perseus had also stopped at Larissa to participate in the funeral games for the king's father. Perseus's discus throw struck Acrisius in the head, killing him, and thus completing the prophecy. In another version, Acrisius was exiled because his brother, Proetus, had seized the throne. Perseus turned Proetus to stone and restored Acrisius to the throne. However, Acrisius did not believe Perseus about his feat of having slain the lady Medusa, accusing him of lying. Perseus then reveals the Gorgon head, turning the king to stone. Ashamed of having achieved the throne via regicide, Perseus allows Megapenthes, the son of Proetus, to take the throne. A very similar situation occurs in the city of Troy, where King Laomedon had his daughter chained to a rock after an oracle told him it was the only way to appease the sea monster Poseidon had sent. Heracles agrees to kill Cetus in exchange for the horses that Zeus had given the king's father as compensation for Ganymede. Laomedon agrees, and Heracles successfully kills the sea monster, but Laomedon goes back on his word. In a later expedition, Heracles sacks Troy and murders all but one of Laomedon's sons. This particular son offered Heracles a golden veil that the Trojan princess had made. Interestingly enough, scholars believe that Greek mythology isn't the only place where Cetus is mentioned. The Hebrew version of the Old Testament uses a word that is best translated as great whale, sea monster, or dragon. For example, Genesis chapter 1, verse 21, in the Hebrew version of the Bible, is best translated as follows. And God created the great sea monsters, and every living creature that creepeth, wherewith the waters swarmed, after its kind, and every winged fowl after its kind. And God saw that it was good. However, the King James version of the book of Genesis replaces the word sea monsters with great whales, among other things, of course. In Psalms chapter 74, verse 13, the Hebrew scripture praises Yahweh, making reference to the events of Exodus, where he had parted the Red Sea to allow safe passage for the Israelites as they escaped Egypt. In Psalms chapter 148, verse 7, a more general praise is directed at God, from all creatures of the earth, including the sea monsters that inhabit the deep ocean. In Ezekiel chapter 32, verse 2, God instructs Ezekiel to confront the Egyptian pharaoh with spite, comparing him to a sea-dwelling dragon instead of a prideful lion. In the book of Jonah, the Hebrew word for great fish was translated as megaketos, in Greek, when describing the whale that devoured Jonah. Finally, the King James Version of Isaiah chapter 27, verse 1, mentions that on the day of judgment, God will slay the dragon in the sea.